Hey, good evening, and welcome back to another stream. To be honest, I have no idea what I'm going to do today, besides painting, of course. I mean, I've been painting so many small details. I feel like maybe paint the trunk? But is that a good idea? Since I'm holding it a lot? I mean, I only got some small inefficiencies because of the many times of grabbing it. It's not too bad, actually. Just some minor stuff. So maybe that's fun to do for today. I mean, it's a huge chunk of the entire piece. It would be nice to get a bit of the feeling of being almost done. Because all the small details, they are very lovely now they are done. But it's a lot of work. I mean, of course you know that, you've been watching, right? Yeah, besides this huge chunk of tree trunk with some, probably some moss and some grass, it's mostly fabrics. One thing of wood, bit of leather, more wood. And of course the little, hopefully soon to be gold little belt. And of course the light, of which I still have no idea what I want to do with it. So just let that circle in my brain for a bit more. So yeah, why not? Just paint this thing. And see what more I'm able to do if I finish this today. So of course it's going to be brown, because wood, you know. But also green in different shades. Let me quickly check some ideas. Pinterest, my big friend. Tree and moss. Ooh, I like that. Okay, I've got a nice idea. I'm going to save that image for later. Downloads. So this image I'm looking at right now, it's a lighter type of wood, but it has one, two, three different kinds of moss on it, including that apparently it's called lichen. It's the very pale green little pancake type of moss. Sounds weird, Linda. Yeah, I know. But I think these things here could be just that. Which would be interesting. And on top is definitely a longer type of moss. which could be this one. Let's download that as well. Save for later, yes please. Let's see, which colors do I have for that? I think that could work. So this one. Let's do the clothes. I'm gonna have to mix some greens because the colors, the green colors from scale color are they're quite vibrant and I don't need vibrant right now. That's okay, I'll find something. As for the woods, so these for the woods. This color for the lichen, or however you pronounce that. I will have to mix some other greens with this as a base. So let's just start that idea. Almost wanted to grab my purple for the shadows. No. No purple here. Stop it. Red and black for the shadow. Green and white for the highlight. So I think I'm going to quite sloppily paint the brown on there. And sloppily maybe isn't the correct word for it. Because if you paint it wet on wet, it will do its own thing. Like it will mix with the other color by itself. Which really helps with natural looking things. So kind of wet paint magic. Sounds logical. Yeah, thank you. A new one, I think. Yes. And let's shake that first. Thank you. brown. This one is so new, I still have to open it. Don't shoot out, please. Not too bad. Brown. And a bit of red. Let's have that on hand already. As well, green and some whites. And apparently there was still some brown in my brush. Shit. Okay. Let's just slap some paint on there. I have three different shades of brown, and I'm just going to use them, all three of them, randomly. quite scary to paint that close to the tail. So let's not rush that part. Flex in the tail, but not too much. Let's not grab the mouse with paint hands. Something like that, I think. So let's let it dry for a bit. And after this, of course, I'm going to add the shadows and the highlights. As far as that is needed, I have to check how much moss there actually is. Because it's a bit of a shame if you put in a lot of effort for all the highlights and such and then cover it with moss anyway. I will check. Thank you. drop it. I mean, that green on top isn't the right green, but it gives a nice effect. Shadows. So I just made a mixture with black and red, thinned it down a lot. Now I will place the shadows on the shadow side of the mini. That's not completely dry yet, but it'll mix. Thank you. I'm just trying to find all the spots where the shadow would be, keeping in mind that light is coming in from this side. So as you can see here, the light points that I kept are all in the same spot, and of course below I want it a bit darker to keep the focus on the top. So there's always a lot of things to keep in mind. Luckily, there's the stuff I like. So from this side as well, try not to grab the wet parts. Maybe a bit more dark at the bottom. Same here, the complete backside is dark. Light coming in from here. Probably need to add a bit more on the other side. There. I mean, I gotta keep it consistent. Would be nice to have a blow dryer at this moment, which I have, but I don't have any power sockets left. So maybe just plug out the computer, blow dry it real fast, plug it back in. Yeah. I'll just gonna have to wait. So. I mean, it's hot enough. Will dry fast enough, I'm sure. No wet paints. No. Old fashioned way. color will be perfect. How should I tackle this? Let's thin it down a bit. I want to add the lichen thingies first before I work on the wood more. Because it might be easier to add the highlights and such when I know where to highlight. There's a lot of this stuff on the tree trunk, which is pretty cool if you ask me, because it will break up all the brown tones. Nothing wrong with brown, but there's a lot of brown going on already. It stands out a lot at the moment, but I know where I'm going with the colors. Maybe I see more of the plan as you do at the moment. Trust me. Thank you. wonder if this is what the sculptor had in mind at all. I mean, I always think about stuff like that when painting a mini. Because I'm sure the sculptor had some kind of idea about how it should look with colors. And I really hope I'm doing it justice. Nice to not have to be very precise. Keep your hand as still as possible. Just let it shake. I mean, maybe it's something totally different as what they had in mind, but I like it. Another shadow over the entire piece where the shadow part is. So if I do that with the first highlight on, you will get two tones, so a base and a shadow, a base and a highlight, sorry. And then if you cover it with a shadow color, you still have those two tones but darker. So it's a bit of a speedy thing. I think it's going to work. I'm just going to try. Let's see. Create a highlight. Oof, my wet palette is so dry. I mean, I'm glad it's cooler as it was yesterday. Yesterday we suddenly had 32 degrees Celsius, which is hot, especially in the Netherlands where it is partially below sea level. This climate isn't made for 30 plus. But today it's 24, something like that. So I can kind of paint, but the wet palette dries really quickly. Okay, let's highlight this in frame. It feels too white. that. Okay, so the idea now is to add the shadows. Maybe it was a better idea to do this at the same time as the wood. But I'm just going to keep the layer thin and see where it takes me. So just a red and black tint down very far. I mean, very far. Okay, let's see. Same as before. Everything that feels like a shadow. I mean, it already works. The highlights here are way brighter as here. I do think I need another coat. I think I'm still a bit too careful. Thank you. I mean, from the front, the eyes still look very weird. Let's just not look at him from this side, okay? Just ignore it. But I really like this. It still needs the last highlight, same as for the wood, of course. This long type of moss still needs some color. But I'm not mad about this, no. Let's see. Bit more white for that last highlight. Really see which parts need that last highlight. The long moss first, so I know up to where I need to put the brown. Let's check. that is quite right. And that green might actually be the correct one. Brush was right in front of me and I didn't see it. It's very in your face. Luckily I still have to add black and red to it, so adding the red will make it a bit more brown. That is way better. And it is the shadow color. That looks more natural. our brush. Ever paint this mini again. Remind me to paint the deepest parts first. I'm so afraid I'm messing up those perfect little hands. Oh well, nothing to be done about it now. I'll fix it later. Yeah. Hey, good evening. Sorry about that. I was fighting the last bit of paint I had on my palette. I really didn't want to mix more. So I needed to quickly slap it on there. Temperature is quite rising in the room with the door closed. But it looks good. Too bright. It feels like this is catching a lot of attention, pulling away from what's there. So let's fix that. Just going to grab that base color I used, thin it down a lot. Hey, good evening. Welcome to slapping paints as fast as possible because it's hot. I need to go a bit darker even. Let's just wait for this layer to dry and see from there. Kettle's pretty good if you ask me. Let me zoom in for you. What do you think? Does it look like a kettle? Today I am working on some different types of moss and wood. That helped. It's not as bright anymore. It does not pull too much attention away. maybe it can be a bit darker. Like this side is good. It's not pulling away the attention of the main characters here. This might still be a bit too bright. I mean, it's pretty, sure, but it shouldn't pull attention away. Still have the tiniest amount of red and black on the palette. Well, I mean, if you need some tips, you can always ask me. I mean, I started like any other painter, and I've just tried everything that came to mind, doing the weirdest shit, and it somehow got me here. So if I can do that, I can help you get in a good start. I mean, of course, I can't do magic, unfortunately, but I can help. Make it make it a bit less visible there. I mean, of course you can see it, but the camera will behave a bit better. Whatever you do, don't aim for the highest techniques that are out there. I mean, many people make the mistake of wanting to do everything while they are still learning. Just pick something, focus on that, and once you think you've finished that, then go to the next one. When I first started, I wanted to be able to do everything. Like, the blends had to be perfect. The highlights had to be super sharp. I wanted to do non-metallic metal. But I didn't even understand colors yet and how to thin my paints properly. So just start somewhere, okay? Don't go crazy. You have all the time in the world. Some colors for a attempt to highlight. Probably way too bright, but I can always darken it down. Hey, good evening. Welcome. Problem. I mean, you're sure you've got more to do than just watch somebody paint. This definitely is way too bright. Already, so I'm going to use this at least at the highlighted parts. Well, that's very important too. Not a fun job, but it has to happen. I mean, on Friday I was late because I was cleaning the apartment, so it happens.
Okay.
So that, of course, looks a bit weird. But I will add a brown glaze over that. And then add highlights, doing it again, shadows over that. Always make a mistake while painting, and then you can do two things. You can start over, or you just work with what you have. And in this case, I don't think it's that bad. It's just not what I had in mind. So I'm going to adjust it till I am satisfied with it. I used three different shades of brown for the original wood colors. So I'm going to use them in the same way as before, just randomly placing them. I mean, it is wood. Wood isn't just brown, one shade of brown. So I'm just playing with it. Pick that up. And more important, is it only on my hands? It is. I was afraid I might have placed it somewhere on the mini. I have no idea how it got there. Yeah, light and shadows are challenging indeed. I mean, I wanted to say, of course it's easy when you know where to place them, but to get to that point... So, for instance, this mini, I decided that the light is coming in from this way. So, of course, everything in the opposite color will be dark. Like, be dark, but dark beneath and highlights on top. But every shape has its own way of how to place a shadow and a highlight. I mean, look at his face. Maybe zoom in a bit. There are many shapes on this little head. You have an edge above his eye. You have the deepest part underneath his eye, which may sound more logic to place a highlight of a shadow there, because it's a deep part. But if you turn it and you look directly at it from the point where your light is coming from, you see that this is actually still visible, which means it's not a shadow. Everything that isn't visible from this point, like here next to his eye, which has a shadow. So it's very important to look at your miniature from different angles. So the first highlight was this entire piece, so his little cheek. Then I added that extra ridge with a brighter highlight, but also every curve has a highlight. Like, look at the glove. There's not just a highlight here, but also around the edges, because of how light works. Same with his face. Come on. So it's not just that part, but also the edge. So the edge between the lightest part and darkest part, because after this highlight it becomes dark. I mean, does that sound a bit logic at least? Patches in here. I don't know if you know the exact type of moss I try to paint with. And I don't mean if you know the name, but at least you've seen this type before. Thank you. bit of a shadow back in there. Black and red. Multiple coats of very thin shadow and one too thick. I like the color though. When it's wet. Side, I want that light to come in like this. So probably just this part here that needs a bit of light. Let's look from above. Yeah, as you can see, it's just this part and it stops around here. So everything below that needs to be darker. That's almost dry, so let's just go for it. only this part will catch a bit of light. I do think the wood looks interesting. Oh, I can zoom out further. I mean, at first it looked very bland, which is something I don't do. I don't allow that. But I think I've created some life into it. Even on the shadow side, it does not look boring. There isn't just one color, it's not just black. I mean, I'm trying to keep in mind what they told me with the previous competition. Like, there has to be a visual point that is the most interesting, and you can't just have everything be interesting. Because you have to look at the main character at an instance. I am not there yet. I mean, he needs more highlights on his face, and the mouse probably a bit too. He needs more though. He is the main character, then the mouse, then the rest. So, yes, I do need highlights, but they can't be too bright. They can't pull too much attention away. And this is all stuff I try to keep in mind. That in combination with the fact that I want my shadow to be quite dark to show off how bright the light actually is. But I don't want to go too crazy because that doesn't work in my head for some reason. I mean, there's a lot of thoughts going on at the same time. But I think I'm going into the right direction with this. Like, from here, you can see what I meant with just this patch here. The rest is darker. So from the side, it does not pull away attention at all. From the front, it looks a bit more interesting, and then from the top, it's the brightest. So light coming in from here, of course this needs to be the brightest. And I still have to paint this moss, by the way. And then from here as well, it's just this part here, not too much. And then the rest is quite dark. I might even go a bit darker on this side, maybe? at least the too bright paint I used before isn't looking too bright anymore. And by glazing some brown over it, I now have this very neat looking wood that does not look too boring. It does not look too bright. So sometimes it's just better to just keep on going instead of start over. I mean, if you keep starting over, in the end you have nothing to show besides a chunky looking miniature with too much paint on it. So just use your mistakes, learn from them, work with it. I've had it before with a samurai miniature. She's a bust, lots of skin going on, and she turned out way too pink. So at that point I was thinking, do I start over? Do I try again? But if I would fail in the second attempt, my brain would already think like, okay, you suck, you cannot do this, just stop. But because I just kept on going, I'm training my brain to think in solutions, try to find out what does work, and these are all lessons that will stick to you, and you can use it in your next paint job. All that in combination with the fact that you told your brain you can do it. So that stuff really helps, if you ask me. I mean, nothing sucks more as thinking you can't do it. Been there. And I mean, look at what I'm painting now. Yeah, I totally suck. Let's paint a bit of that moss and see what that does. Let's see, where is my point of light? You can learn. Really can. Exactly. I mean, if you don't make mistakes, you will never learn. Just keep on making mistakes. Don't let it stop you. just adding some random dabs of green here and there. I mean, it's a mossy tree trunk. There can be so many shades of green. So I'm just playing around with some colors. Try to not be too afraid. To the long grassy moss that I'm going to bring back in that shadow. Spots where to place the highlights. For today, I really want to finish this part first. Thank you. This miniature is called the Traveler, which is very fitting. Look it up, and I'm sure you will recognize it in the painting, just with that weird color. But yeah, I have to end the stream for tonight, unfortunately. So yeah, well, I will take some pictures for Instagram. I will be back next Friday, so same time as today, and is there something there? I feel like there was something I would say. No idea. Never mind. Anyway, thank you for being here tonight. Thank you for the fun chats with which I could explain some things. It's always nice to talk to somebody. And yeah, I would wish you a good rest of the day, good luck with work and everything, and hopefully see you next Friday. And of course, if you have more questions about painting, just send me a message on Instagram. I will try my best to help you out with whatever question you have. If it's more about shadow or light, something else, just ask. I will be there, okay? So, see you next time. Bye.